Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In today's episode, I'm going to tell you about a disaster in my life. Okay, I'm dramatic here, but I'm going to tell you the solution, namely Git Switch and Git Restore, two new commands that came along in Git 2.23. I could, of course, just tell you what happened to me and how Git Restore and Git Switch make sure that it doesn't happen in the future, but first of all, that would make this episode really short, and second, it wouldn't be as memorable for you, and you would not perhaps go to the extreme and get rid of that evil command. Building up the tension here, let's go to the show. So let's go back to the beginning. You gotta love the drama here. The beginning, that is when I have absolutely nothing here except a simple Git repository. Git status, there's nothing there yet. So we'll cat out into main.cpp and we'll just the beginning. There we are. In the beginning, I had main.cpp. I added main.cpp here. I did some work on it and I git commit minus m the start. So now I have a version in my Git repository. I also had a checkout minus b of some work. So now, as you can see here in my command prompt, it says some work. That means that I'm on that branch that's called some work. Okay, I'm on that branch. And the first thing that I'd like to show you is this really neat version of checkout with minors. That's used for switching branches. So I switched, instead of explicit specifying, I want to git check out some underscore work like that. I could just, I'm over there now. I could just say git check out or co, which is just an alias for me to switch between the branches. Switch or restore. I'm getting ahead of myself here. I already realized I would get in trouble there, so I changed my alias there. So git checkout minors, you can see I jump between the branches. So I'm now on my master branch. I make some changes here. Cat into main.cpp, five hours of work. So I've been working for 5 hours on these things, and of course I should have set up my backup every 10 minutes, which I didn't at the point that this disaster hit me, because at this stage I realized, this work, I really should go onto the other branch, or I wanted to go to the other branch and check it out or whatever, and I hadn't done a git commit for 5 hours and I didn't have my backup. So I wanted to go to the other branch, so I git check out. I did git, not fit, not gear, git check out my dot, not minus. Oh my God. Main.cpp, the beginning. We have this git ref lock that always saves us whenever we're in trouble. Not a word, everything gone. Git checkout, period, means restore back to what the index looked like. Throw away everything that you have there. I hadn't committed. I didn't have a backup, everything was gone. Minus, it should have been, dot, it was, and therefore instead of switching to the other branch, I threw away all my work. So I went to the chat room in KDAB and I whined and I moaned and there was these comforting people around that, why didn't you just commit ever so often? It's like, yeah, I should have done. I don't know why I didn't. You're not really helping me. Somebody else says, why didn't you just use git switch instead of git checkout? Like, you're not help. What? Git switch? I never heard of that one. So I tried git switch and git said, sorry, I didn't know about a switch. My git was too old because this was a new command in 2.23. And what git switch does is that it does the checkout part, or it does the part of git checkout for switching between branches. So git switch minus would have switched me to that other branch, or git switch my work would have got me to that other branch. Git switch period would just have made switch complain, sorry, there's no branch called period. There's another subcommand now called Git Restore, and that's the other part of checkout. That's the part that the Git checkout dot or period did for me, namely restore, throw away what you have here, and get back to what you had in your index. A Git restore, a file name or directory name, meaning everything, does exactly that. So that now I don't use my checkout anymore. It was easy for me to go away from checkout because, as you actually saw, I had an alias already called CO for checkout that I all the time used. And as you saw, I just print out a message saying, you are just insane, you shouldn't be using CO. Unfortunately, and I looked into this just as a service for you, it's not possible to remove a command entirely from Git, but in the links below, I found a Stack Overflow page where you set up a shell alias that will make checkout not, no, it'll just, when you run Git checkout, it will actually run an alias called Git, and it will check whether you actually run checkout and complain. There are, I learned, one feature of checkout not covered by restore and switch, namely when I do a Git bisect, when I want to go back and I start Git bisect bat on my current commit, and then I want to find something in the past and find a SHA that I want to go back to. And Git switch do not allow you to specify a generic SHA. It allows you to specify a branch name. So there you can't use Git switch. In those situations, you actually do need Git checkout still. So if you use that script that I linked to below, then somebody please update it and even put a version on Stack Overflow or below here with one that checks whether it's or allows you another alias or something that actually allows you to do a checkout with a SHA. That's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. Hopefully that solves you from losing 5 hours of work. My bank account number is below. Just send me the money that you would have wasted. Never mind. I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time, have a great time.
Are you having trouble solving a problem in your software project? Talk to us and see if we can help with our consulting services.